Okay, I'm going to speak about this parabola and obtaining the focus and the directrix. We know how to get vertex and axis of symmetry, or axis of symmetry then vertex. Axis of symmetry is minus b over 2a. So that's going to be a minus 6 over 2 times 1, which is negative 3. And there's negative 3 right there for the axis of symmetry, which that's the x value for the vertex. And then you plug the axis of symmetry back into the function, so you have minus 3 squared, which gives you a 9, plus this 6 times a minus 3 is a minus 18, and then you add 7, and so that's minus 9 plus 7, which is a minus 2. So minus 3 minus 2 is the vertex. Let me pause this and clean it up, and I'll write up here that h is minus 3 and k is minus 2. Gosh, that's a great 2. Try to do that a little bit better. Okay, and then let's put this guy in vertex form. So if the vertex is minus 3 minus 2, then it's going to be x plus 3 quantity squared, and then minus 2, and this is going to be y equals, okay, I moved that over here, but I had minus 2, you know, from vertex form, but I threw it over here as a positive 2, because we're about to put it in parabola form. And I'm going to show you one other way you can get to that, is that if you take this 7 off, so that your constant and your y are over here, so I've got y minus 7 is x squared plus 6x. And then if you take half, this is the complete and the square part, you just take half of this linear term and square it, so I'm going to go plus 3 squared, and that's going to make that 9. So I've also got to subtract 9, so I'm going to close this off like this, and I'm going to put minus 9 just to keep things balanced. And then you can write this as, you know, a perfect square. Now you can write it as x plus 3 quantity squared, and then you got to put your minus 9 here, because you're putting something there that wasn't there. And then you also gotta, well, if I move that over to this side, watch what'll happen. If I add 9 here, that's supposed to be a plus. And then I add 9 over here, plus 9. This is gonna become a y plus 2, and you can see this is the exact thing as this. Right, let me clean this up, and I'll show you about taking a fourth of this left side, pulling off a fourth to get a value known as p, and And why it's P, I don't know, but it's the letter P in most textbooks. Let me pause this. Okay, I put the standard form of a. So just forget about this 4P, and if you just look at it, it's just Y minus K right here, which that's not K, it's the opposite of K. Where the vertex is, you take the opposites. So this is, and then this 4P is what we're talking about. It's just, let's see, we're just talking about that 4P. The 4 is always 4. The P is going to change based on, you've got to wrap this guy and then put a 4 here. And in the next video, I'll show you why it's a 4. But put a 4 here, and then the P is whatever keeps it the same, which is just going to be, this is going to be 1/4. And that's multiplication. I didn't leave much room, but let me pause it and scoot that 4 over. Okay, and so there's the 4, and the P is going to be 1/4. And what you've got is you, the focus and the vertex, I'm sorry, the focus and the directrix is just plus or minus that P, whatever 4 times is that. So directrix, if it's opening up like this, the directrix is just going to be minus P is the focus minus P. I'm sorry, the vertex minus P is the directrix. And the focus is going to be the vertex, this, plus that P. So let me pause it while I type that out. Okay, I put them in, and I put the P value there. And when I got them backwards, let me reverse it. I got the plus down here and the minus up there. Let me change it. Okay, and then, so common denominator, this would be minus 8/4. Minus 8/4. I'm going to mess. Let me just, I'm about to make it dirty. Let me just pause it and put it in. All right, so minus 8/4, which is minus 2. Minus 8 plus 1/4 is minus, let me change this, minus 7/4. And minus 8 minus 1/4 would be minus 9/4. And that checks out with here. And as you can see, the focus is plus 1/4 over it, and it is down 1/4. And a quick re-mention, these are just points where the distance from this line or the focus have the same distance to any parabola. And I'm about to show you in the next video how why it's a 4 in a sense.